Hello, are you a homeowner thinking of listing your home, thinking of selling your home in 2022? When is the best time to list? Hello, my name is Kristine Glockler with the Glockler Group at Coldwell Banker Realty. I'm going to go over why starting today, April 10th to April 16th, is the best time to list a home in 2022. Now, of course, we know that the spring buying season is here in the Chicago area. April, May, and June are usually the busiest months as far as when sellers list properties for sale and when buyers are out looking. Of course, it can vary year to year, but that's usually what we see. There is a lot of buyer demand right now, and as I mentioned before in other videos, there's not a lot of home inventory supply. So this information is per realtor.com, and they noted here a 29% higher number of buyers viewing listings on realtor.com compared to the average week in 2021. There are a lot of buyers looking because mortgage rates are going up, prices are going up. Speaking of home prices, there's a $39,000 higher asking price than at the beginning of the year based on 2021 trends. In our local market, majority of our markets here in the Chicago suburbs, the areas in which we work, the monthly supply of inventory, the time it would take to sell all of the inventory for sale, is under a month. In some communities, it's actually 2 weeks. So properties are selling quicker, which now it's so important in this market or in any market to work with a highly professional, reputable realtor who goes over the market and can go over the, if you receive multiple offers, can go over the offers with you, because there are a lot of intricacies in offers and in transactions and multiple offers. And so you need to work with someone who really can go over all that with you and explain that to you and they're with you every step of the process. There are multiple steps in the home selling and home buying process. So because our busiest months here are usually April, May, and June, we're towards the beginning of that busy season. So usually there is less competition if you're thinking of listing your home now than there would be a month or two from now. So keep that in mind. And it could be, you know, no one can predict the future, but for buyers, usually as we approach summer, there's more inventory to choose from. There's more sellers. So there's more competition for sellers, but there's also more competition for buyers because usually more buyers enter the market. This week, April 10th to the 16th, there's less competition. They're saying there's 12.9% fewer sellers with homes actively listed than during an average week of 2021. Now, this market is unique because mortgage rates are going up, and actually they're increasing pretty quickly. And a lot of people are stating that there are going to be multiple rate hikes before the end of the year. And some people say, you know, gone are the days of having rates where they were last year or in 2020. Refinances have gone down, the number of refinances. So the more a buyer pays as far as a mortgage rate, the more they pay as far as he, she, they pay as far as a home price, the more the monthly payment is going to be. So keep that in mind whether you are looking to sell or buy. As mortgage rates increase, buyer affordability decreases. Now, this is what you want to do to get your home list ready. These are 5 steps to prep your home for sale. Now, the first is really to talk with a highly experienced, local, proactive real estate agent. If you're looking in the Chicago suburbs, let's have a conversation. Let's talk about your goals, what you're looking to accomplish as a home seller. You also want to, and I go over this in our pre-listing appointments with our seller clients, is you want to make a list of the upgrades in the home, the ages of the roof, windows, systems, mechanicals, appliances. Not only is that important when establishing a list price, but buyers also want to know the age of those items, and it's really imperative to give an appraiser that information as well. They are very common questions that buyers ask, and with good reason, because roofs are very costly, and if a property needs a new roof, that is something that a buyer wants to know. Or if it's near the end of the roof life, so to speak. So you want to walk through, ideally do a walkthrough of your home. Look and see if there's anything that needs to be fixed or painted, and look on the ceiling if there's anything that may need to be touched up or painted on the walls, the ceiling. Replace any light bulbs that may need to be replaced. Look at your property from the outside. Curb appeal. Make sure that first impression really is a great one, and make sure things work. We've been getting a lot of rain here in the Chicago suburbs, so check out all areas of your home, especially the exteriors or any rotted wood, etc. Now, you want to have an idea whether you want to sell your home as is, which means that a seller is not going to make any repairs, or if you are open to repairs. Now, it really depends on the seller's situation, and it can sometimes make buyers a little bit more concerned if a property is sold as is. Now, if it's sold as is because there are a lot of items on the disclosure and the buyer's then given that and the seller doesn't want to fix it, it's one thing. Some people don't have the time or the resources to do any work inside a home. So decide where you are in that as far as repairs or no repairs. And of course, you want to make sure your home is clean. Go through, and usually less is more in photos. You want to dust and vacuum and clean your home, clean that front door, make sure all the windows are clean, etc. Make sure your home shows very, very well. You have one chance to make a first impression online, where most buyers start their home search. So I hope you found this information helpful. Again, if you are looking to buy or sell in the Chicago suburbs or southern Wisconsin, I'm also licensed in Wisconsin, let's have a conversation. If you are thinking of selling, it's certainly the best time to list this week. Thank you and have a great day.